and height and breadth. Whose image is not known through idols made of stone, nor gold, nor human wealth, nor strength.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
Dios es bueno.
Alleluia.
Mi Dios es bueno.
Alleluia.
Me ha salvado.
Alleluia.
Me ha salvado.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Me ha perdonado.
Alleluia.
Me ha rescatado.
Alleluia.
Me ha rescatado.
Alleluia.
Aleluya, 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 el Señor.
pecado.
Aleluya.
Me ha perdonado.
Aleluya.
Me ha rescatado.
Aleluya.
Me ha rescatado.
Aleluya.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, peace be with you. We gather this afternoon for the closing Eucharistic liturgy of the Religious Education Congress 2017. We give thanks to God for all the graces that we have received these days, and ask also for the grace to renew our commitment to be faithful to God and to become missionary disciples. Let's start our celebration humbly asking the Lord our God to bless this water. Where is the water? It's over there, everywhere. Over there. Okay. It's coming. Over there. To bless this water, He has created, which will be sprinkling on us as a memorial of our baptism. May He help us by His grace to remain faithful to the Spirit we have received. Almighty, ever-living God, who willed that through water, the fountain of life and the source of purification, even souls should be cleansed and receive the gift of eternal life. Be pleased, we pray, to bless this water, by which we seek protection on this your day, O Lord. Renew the living spring of your grace within us, and grant that by this water we may be defended from all ills of spirit and body, and so approach you with hearts made clean and worthy receive your salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Generations come forth and receive.
agua bendita que da libertad a todo el que vive cautivo. Agua que trae justicia y verdad a todo el que vive oprimido.
Water of life, holy reminder, touching, renewing the body of Christ. Agua de vida, santo recuerdo.
May Almighty God cleanse us of our sins, and through the celebration of this Eucharist, make us worthy to share at the table of His kingdom. Amen.
Glorificamos, te damos gracias, Señor Dios, Rey Celestial, Dios Padre Todopoderoso.
Gloria, gloria a Dios.
Lord Jesus Christ,
Let us pray. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that the course of our world may be directed by your peaceful rule, and that your church may rejoice untroubled in her devotion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Lời Chúa trích trong sách tiên tri Isaiah. Sion nói, Chúa bỏ rơi tôi, Chúa đã quên tôi rồi. Nào người mẹ có thể quên con mình, mà không thương xót chính đứa con mình đã cư mang ư. Cho dù người mẹ đó có quên, nhưng ta sẽ không quên người đâu. The word of the Lord.
Descansa solo en Dios, descansa solo en Dios. Rest in God alone, my soul. Descansa solo en Dios, descansa solo en Dios. Rest in God alone, my soul. From him comes my salvation. He only is my rock, and he only is my salvation, my stronghold, my stronghold. I shall not be distressed.
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Corintios. Hermanos, procuren que todos nos consideren como servidores de Cristo y administradores de los misterios de Dios. Ahora bien, lo que se busca en un administrador es que sea fiel. Por eso, lo que menos me preocupa es que me juzguen ustedes o un tribunal humano, pues ni siquiera yo me juzgo a mí mismo. Es cierto que mi conciencia no me reprocha nada, pero no por eso he sido declarado inocente. El Señor es quien habrá de juzgarme. Por lo tanto, No juzguen antes de tiempo. Esperen a que venga el Señor. Entonces Él sacará a la luz lo que está oculto en las tinieblas. Pondrá al descubierto las intenciones del corazón y dará a cada uno la alabanza que merezca. Palabra de Dios.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "No one can serve two masters. He will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and mammon. Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, or what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the sky. They do not sow or reap. They gather nothing into barns, but your heavenly Father feeds them. Are not you more important than they? Can any of you, by worrying, add a single moment to your lifespan? Why are you anxious about clothes? Learn from the way the wild flowers grow. They do not work or spin. But I tell you that not even Solomon in all his splendor was clothed like one of them. If God so clothes the grass of the field, which grows today and is thrown into the oven tomorrow, will he not much more provide for you, O you of little faith? So do not worry and say, what are we to eat? Or what are we to drink? Or what are we to wear? All these things the pagans seek. Your heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given you besides. Do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Sufficient for a day is its own evil. The Gospel of the Lord.
Del corazón.
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I hope that you are happy that I was able to find the water. I was nervous. Especially because embrace trust. Trusting in God, and I couldn't find the water. I hope you have you all have had a great weekend. Isn't it wonderful to be together to pray and worship God? Thanks be to God for giving us the blessing of coming together to renew our to renew our faith and our missionary vocation. Una gran alegría estar juntos este fin de semana como la familia de Dios. Y estoy seguro que hemos renovado nuestro compromiso de fe y nuestro entusiasmo misionero. First of all, I want to thank all of you for your prayers for our immigrants and refugees. As we know, we are living in a time of transition in our country. Things feel uncertain, and people are afraid. So it is beautiful to be able to be here to pray and to support one another. The Catholic Church, as we know, has a deep commitment to the poor, to the immigrant and the refugee. It is a historic commitment, part of who we are as Catholics. In our country, we are an immigrant church. This is who we are. Our people have 1,000 stories, and we tell our stories in every language. Todos somos una familia. Todos somos la familia de Dios. So we need to keep standing together. We need to keep our eyes on Jesus. We need to keep trusting in God, in good times and in bad, en las buenas y en las malas. Les agradezco sus oraciones por nuestros hermanos y hermanas inmigrantes y refugiados. Somos una familia universal y seguimos muy unidos, rezando y trabajando para que todos vivamos en paz y juntos podamos construir un mundo mejor. Toda nuestra confianza está en Dios, que es nuestro Padre. El tema de nuestro congreso, confía. Trust in God. This has been our theme this weekend, and it is the right message for these times we are living in. In the gospel today, Jesus says, "Therefore, I tell you, do not worry about your life. Why are you anxious?" I think our Lord is challenging us today to surrender ourselves to God, to give ourselves to Him, to trust in His will for our lives. Jesus teaches us today that God holds this world, all of this beautiful creation, with all of its messiness and its sin and sorrow, He holds all of this in His loving hands. Jesús nos enseña hoy que Dios Padre, en su providencia, tiene un plan de amor y felicidad para cada uno de nosotros. Nos ama a cada uno como un padre bueno y tiene un gran deseo de que nuestras vidas estén llenas de paz y seguridad. Con Dios lo podemos todo. Y nos dice, yo nunca me olvidaré de ti. Jesus teaches us today that God loves us with a parent's love. And like every loving parent, He has a beautiful dream for our lives. We heard those beautiful words of the prophet Isaiah today in our first reading. Can a mother forget her infant, be without tenderness for the child of her womb? Even should she forget, I will never forget you. My brothers and sisters, when I reflected on these words this week, I immediately remember my mother. I can say many wonderful things about her, but obviously for me, she was my mother. She loved me and my sisters with no conditions. And I had total trust in her because she was my mother. Now, the prophet Isaiah, in a sense, says that God loves me more than my mother. Amazing. I will never forget you. And it really makes sense to trust in God. As our theme song goes, embrace trust. Trust in God, who is our rock, who is our strength. As you probably noticed in the last few years, I like to talk about the examples of the saints, especially missionary saints, because I really believe that we are the missionaries of the 21st century. Just yesterday, someone was talking to me about the fact that in a few days, on March 13, we will celebrate the fourth anniversary of the election of Pope Francis. And he was asking me, this person was asking me, about what has impressed me the most in Pope Francis' pontificate. There are obviously many things that are just wonderful in the ministry of Pope Francis. And I was thinking of one that is, I think, is very special for Pope Francis, and that's his insistence on our call to be missionary disciples. The Pope really wants us to be a missionary church, una iglesia en salida, a church that goes out in mission. And he has given us the great gift of canonizing four of the first missionaries who came to the American continent: Saint Junipero Serra, Saint José de Anchieta, Saint Francis Laval, and Saint Marie of the Incarnation. Como ustedes saben, ya se habrán dado cuenta que me gusta recordar el ejemplo de los santos misioneros del continente americano. Hoy les comento de Santa María de la Encarnación, que fue misionera en Canadá en el siglo XVII. Saint Marie of the Incarnation was one of the founders of the church in Canada, and she was an amazing woman, a wife, a mother, a mystic, and later a religious sister and missionary who came to this continent from the 17th century France. Saint Marie loved the native peoples of this continent, and she learned the indigenous languages. She even wrote catechism for the Native Americans. She established the first school for girls in the New World. She was a master catechist, an educator. This is the Religious Education Congress. So she's a beautiful example for all of us. And in her writings, everything comes back to trust in God. God, she said, God never led me by a spirit of fear, but by love and trust. She's right. And my dear brothers and sisters, God is calling us to be missionaries, just like her, just like the other three saints that Pope Francis has canonized since he became the Pope 4 years ago. And God will give us the strength we need in every moment. He will give us the grace to be the missionary saints of the 21st century. But we have to trust him. Like Saint Marie, we need to forget about ourselves and see only Jesus and speak to him in prayer, from the heart. Santa María de la Encarnación dedicó su vida a la evangelización de los indígenas en Canadá. Y en sus enseñanzas y escritos, todo se resumía en la confianza en Dios. Decía, Dios nunca me lleva al temor, sino al amor y a la confianza. Su vida y ejemplo nos llevan a aprender a poner toda nuestra confianza y nuestro amor en Dios, y nuestra mirada en Jesús. And when we do this, when we trust in God, when we keep our eyes only on Jesus, Then we will hear his voice in our hearts. These words that we heard today in the gospel: seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things we will be given you besides. Do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Like Saint Marie, like all the holy men and women who evangelize the Americans, today Jesus is calling us to be missionary disciples in our time and place. Jesus is calling us to make this world into God's kingdom. He's calling us to bring God's mercy and justice and truth into every corner of this world. So, my dear brothers and sisters, let us go forward this week and every day, always forward, siempre adelante. Let us stay close to Jesus and let us know that he goes with us and that his holy angels guide us and guard us. And let us especially ask our Blessed Mother Mary to help us always to trust in God. He loves us more than even our mothers. Amazing. And to seek his will in all things, to become the missionary saints of the 21st century. Renovemos hoy con alegría y entusiasmo nuestra llamada misionera. Somos los santos misioneros del siglo XXI. What a beautiful responsibility. What an exciting call to go out and preach the gospel and share the beauty of what we have lived this weekend with everybody else out there. Isn't it amazing? Amen. It's not just us here having a good time. No, it's not like the Oscars, you know? I think these are happening tonight, no? Or next week? Tonight, okay. I'm glad that I found the water. Los santos misioneros del siglo XXI, siempre cerca de Jesús, sabiendo que con él lo podemos todo, diciéndole cada minuto de nuestra vida que toda nuestra confianza está puesta en él. And we go to the intercession of Mary, our Blessed Mother, Our Lady of Guadalupe, Mother of God and our Mother, Our Lady of Guadalupe, Queen of the Americans. Let's ask her to continue to protect us and to fire in us the desire to go out and really be the saints, the missionary saints of the 21st century. Que viva la Virgen de Guadalupe. So where do I go?
I now invite forward all catechumens.
Not yet.
I now invite forward all catechumens who are on the journey toward baptism. Thank you.
catechumens, the Church gathered here now sends you forth to reflect more deeply upon the Word of God, which you have shared with us today. We send you with our blessing and love, and look forward with great trust to that day when we will embrace one another around the table of the Eucharist. Go in peace. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth.
All is visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things are made.
My brothers and sisters, we trust in God, our rock and salvation. Let us put out our hearts before him in prayer for the needs of all our world.
Let us pray for the church throughout all the world.
Xin Chúa ban ơn cho Đức Thánh Cha Francisco, cho Ngài luôn hướng dẫn giới trẻ đặt niềm tin vững vàng vào tình yêu của Chúa.
Roguemos para que todos los que seguimos a Cristo no dudemos en extender un abrazo fraternal a los que se sienten temerosos y abandonados.
We pray to the Lord.
God of trust.
Let us pray for the peacemakers who are builders of trust in every land.
Xin Chúa gìn giữ và ban cho các nhà lãnh đạo của quốc gia chúng ta ơn khôn ngoan, chín chắn và lòng nhân hậu.
Roguemos por los líderes entre nosotros, en nuestras vecindades, familias y lugares de trabajo, quienes inspiran puentes de confianza entre los pueblos.
We pray to the Lord.
Let us pray for all those who suffer, for those who are ill, and those who hunger or thirst.
Xin cầu nguyện cho những ai sống trong cô đơn, những người tị nạn và những người sống ngoài lìa của xã hội.
Roguemos por los que viven bajo el yugo de la pobreza, violencia y la opresión.
For his healing peace upon the suffering, we pray to the Lord.
God of trust, hear our prayer. O Señor, escúchanos.
Let us pray for those who have died. For those who have died from violence in war-torn lands or in our own neighborhoods.
Xin cầu nguyện cho những ai đã qua đời trong cô đơn và quên lãng.
Roguemos por los que han fallecido hoy.
For all who have died and our own beloved dead, we pray to the Lord.
God of trust, hear our prayer. O Señor,
our stronghold and refuge. You never forsake or abandon your children. Hear these prayers of our hearts, which we raise up to you through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
My brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May your
O God, who provide gifts to be offered to your name, and count our oblations as signs for the desire to serve you with devotion, we ask of your mercy that what you grant as the source of merit may also help us to attain merit's reward. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our dear and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Creator of the world and source of all life. For you never forsake the works of your wisdom, but by your providence are even now at work in our midst. With mighty hand and outstretched arm, you led your people Israel through the desert. Now, as your church makes her pilgrim journey in the world, you always accompany her by the power of the Holy Spirit and lead her along the path of time to the eternal joy of your kingdom through Christ our Lord. And so, with the angels and saints, we too sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. To be glorified, O God, who love the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst, when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send for your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread,
when we eat this bread,
and drink this cup,
we proclaim your death.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion.
And so, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and José, our Bishop, my brother Kevin, the Bishop of this church, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world.
Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life.
Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
World, a banquet hall
from the many makers.
Gustenivean, que buen es el Señor.
y él me respondió, y de todas mis ansias me libró. Taste and see, taste and see that the Lord our God is good. That the Lord our God is good.
Thank you.
bạn hãy niềm tin. Se sometió hasta la muerte y muerte en una cruz. Por eso el Padre lo engrandeció por encima de todo y le concedió el nombre.
And on the cross he died. For this reason God the Father highly exalted him and gave to him the name that there is above every name. No, no.
Let us pray. Nourished by your saving gifts, we beseech your mercy, Lord, that by this same sacrament with which you feed us in the present age, you may make us partakers of life eternal. Through Christ our Lord.
Did you enjoy Congress this weekend? ¿Ya disfrutaron todo? Mil gracias a todos ustedes que han acompañado a nosotros en este fin de semana del Congreso Confía y todo el esfuerzo que han hecho por estar aquí y de presentarle con todo su corazón. I want to thank you so much for taking this time to dedicate to this weekend, to be with us, and to open your hearts to embrace trust. So thank you to all of you for all that you have done and brought here this weekend. I'd like to thank our Youth Ministry Division for our Youth Day. What are you waiting for? Especially Victoria and Katie and Heather and the Youth Day core team. So thank you, our Youth Ministry Division. Fantastic day. From our committees, our Liturgy Committee, Registration, the Congress Committee, our Environment and Art Committee, which includes Valerie McRae, Linda Rehm, and Joseph Shepherd. They helped our birds to fly, and they helped us to experience the beauty of nature in sacred space in our Laudato Si exhibit, so thank you so much. I also like to thank all of our volunteer coordinators. Thank you so much, Ramona and Anna and Salvador and all of you that worked so hard to be able to bring us all of our volunteers. To all of our speakers, our new speakers, yeah, thank you. We have like 1,500 volunteers. It's so much work. It's amazing. Gracias por todo su trabajo. For our speakers, especially our new ones, thank you for sharing us your talents and your gifts. The exhibitors, for bringing us so many wonderful things to help us in our ministry. For our service teams, the Blue Angels, the Yellow Jackets, the mobility team, and for the team that helps and work with those who are deaf and hard of hearing, our interpreters, thank you so much for all of your hard work. So thank you. For our production, Janelle Friedrichsen and Maria Alderetti, thank you for keeping us wired and keeping us moving. Video cam, John Arnold and his crew. For sound, Drew Aldridge and the audio tech crew. Bright Ideas, John Vasquez and his crew. For live streaming, Dan House, John Vogt, and for helping us with live stream interview, Alex Venegas and all the team there. For our sacristy team, Brian Custer, Mike Fike, Marianne Nguyen, and all their staff, which includes our LMU and Mount St. Mary University students. So thank you for all of your work. All of the musicians that shared their talents this weekend, through all of our liturgies, the concerts, all of that effort, and all of our musicians who are here with us this evening, thank you. For our ministers of liturgical movement, enhancing our prayer with movement, thank you so much. For the coordinators of our liturgies, and especially to Elizabeth Mullen and Margaret Traxler, who coordinate the 2 days of our liturgies, thank you for all of your hard work. For Pedro Rubalcava, who wrote our theme song this year, Embrace, Trust, Confía, thank you. For our cantors, Valimar Jansen, Linda Nguyen, Lorenzo Santos, thank you for guiding us in song and prayer. Mary Janice, who coordinated various musicians and the materials for the weekend, thank you. For John Flaherty, the Director of Music for Congress and the Chair of the Liturgical Commission, thank you. He also put together the montage of images for our opening ceremony of the Marian images. So he put that together too. So it was a powerful part of our opening ceremony. So thank you. To my brother priests, I want to thank you for joining us, especially this weekend, as much as you could. And those who heard confessions over the weekend, thank you so much for offering that wonderful ministry. For the deacons and their wives who help serve at liturgies and be present to us, so thank you. And to my wonderful staff, thank you so much to my staff. We have all my staff stand up right now. There you are, stand up. Thank you. Especially to Paulette and Jan, our Congress coordinators, to Joanna and Natalie, their assistants, to Victoria, of course, who are helping with Youth Day in the Youth Ministry Division, and to Chris Krause, who helped us with tech and all kinds of other imagery, so thank you a lot. And to the families, thank you for being widows and widowers for a little while, as we did went to our Congress weekend. So thank you. To Archbishop Gomez, for taking this, for being here with us and sharing us wonderful words of reflection. Our youth really enjoyed your presence, and so did we during this weekend. Thank you so much. I had the joy of going to World Youth Day in Poland and being in so many beautiful places. I know you're out there. Our same pilgrims, you're out there. I know you are. Our Polish rugby bus. There's a story in that, but later. And being in the place, especially in the Chapel of the Divine Mercy, and that theme of the message, Jesus, I trust in you, to come with us, I feel this really has come full circle. De estar en el Jornada Mundial de Jóvenes en Polonia y de estar en la Capilla de Divina Misericordia con este mensaje, Jesús, en ti confío. Yo creo que hemos ya llegado como al círculo en esta jornada a coger a la confianza, de confiar en Dios. Y por eso no es un secreto, no es una sorpresa que tenemos muchas bendiciones este fin de semana. So it's not a surprise that we had so many blessings and graces this weekend. So it's just such a wonderful, wonderful journey. As you heard me in the opening ceremony, I commented that there were 7 young men in the Ventura County Correctional Facility who counted out, separated all the hosts for all the liturgies for this weekend, some 33,000 hosts. They counted out and separated so that we would have that for this weekend. I had asked all of us to pray for them as we went to communion, to think about them, and to hope, to pray that they not lose trust in God, nor that they lose trust in people and those around them who are seeking to help them. And so Katya came up and she gave me these bookmarks that the chaplain from that correctional facility is going to take to them as a way of thanking them for what they did. I'm going to ask all of us now to extend our hands in blessing. I'm going to ask us to bless these, because I'm going to take all this wonderful, wonderful spirit and gift that we just soaked in through this liturgy. I'm going to take these now to these young men and to all who are there, that they not lose hope or trust. Lord God, we give you thanks for this weekend. We ask you to send your blessing to those who feel isolated, alone, who feel they cannot trust in others because their hearts are broken and they've been betrayed. Help them to open their hearts to your mercy and to your grace, that they may trust in you and trust in each other, to trust in their neighbors, so they may continue to grow in faithfulness, holiness, and love. And may your blessing accompany them all throughout their lives, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Pray for them, please, and pray for all those who feel isolated and alone. I feel just amazing energy and love and gratitude. Just so grateful for all of you. Mil gracias a todos ustedes. And I hope to see you all again here next year for Congress 2018 from March 15th, which is Youth Day, to March 18th for the weekend, Congress weekend. And it really, you know, as a kind of something that's very new, a little surprise for you is that I am so happy to announce our theme for Congress 2018. Our theme for next year is Rise Up, Levántate, Hai, Tunglin. And our theme for Youth Day is Dare to Believe. So we hope that we will see you here next year and to join us for Congress 2018. Ojalá que nos vemos el año que viene y estar con nosotros en el Congreso de Educación Religiosa. Mil gracias, que Dios les bendiga. May God bless you on your way home and take this energy and fire into your ministries and your parishes. God bless you.
Please stand for the final blessing. But before the final blessing, Father Chris forgot something.
I sure forgot something. Our lives are filled with comings and goings, and people enter into our lives, they share their gifts, and then God leads them to a continuous path onto what he wants for them. And so we have someone in our midst who shared with us her gift of music and presence, who now is embracing trust to continue her journey in different paths. So I'd like to acknowledge Valimar Jansen as she is going to step down as cantor for our arena liturgies. She's not getting away from Congress, that's for sure. But she is allowing that space now to be filled by others who can share their gifts. And so we want to acknowledge and recognize Valimar for all your many years of service and your voice. Thank you so much.
Before the final blessing, I also want to thank Father Chris Baisouris for his leadership in the Office of Religious Education of the Archdiocese and Congress. And I also want to thank my brother bishops to be with us today. Thank you very much on this weekend. Yeah, good. Wonderful bishops. It's always a challenge to finish Congress. We all wish to stay here for a little longer, don't we? Yes. Well, I know that some of you are going to watch the Oscars tonight. Good luck. But seriously, now we have to go and be the missionary saints of the 21st century. And especially bringing this beautiful team, Embrace Trust, Confia, to the people of our time. We have to be enthusiastic about going and share with them what we have lived here. So I hope that we all do that and see you next year, 2018, in the Religious Education Congress of the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. The Lord be with you. May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit remain with you always.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your life.
Confía, solo en Dios he puesto mi confianza. Confía, solo en Dios he puesto mi confianza. Confía, solo en Dios he puesto mi confianza. amazing closing liturgy of the 2017 Los Angeles Religious Education Congress. We're here, the musicians are still playing, and I'm joined by one of the members of the staff of the Office of Religious Education, Ernesto Vega. How are you?
I'm doing very fine, a little bit tired, but very happy in my heart.
And what were you doing this weekend? Were you leading workshops? Like, what was your involvement?
This weekend, I gave a workshop on spirituality in Spanish. And also, I was leading a group of producers to interview different speakers so that the questions were regarding Quinto Encuentro, so that we can inform the Region 11, the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, about Quinto Encuentro that is coming up this year and the next year.
So what exactly is the Quinto Encuentro? It happens every 10 years or so, right?
Yeah, it's periodically within 10 years or so. And Quinto Encuentro is basically the implementation of the Evangelii Gaudium into the programs, into the pastoral ministry programs, where we are supposed to reflect on how can we develop missionary disciples? How can we go out and share Jesus Christ, the encounter of Jesus Christ with others, especially those who are poor or those who are in the peripheries?
Excellent. Estamos aquí con Ernesto Vega de la Oficina de Educación Religiosa. Ernesto, acabamos de finalizar esta liturgia. Tú eres el encargado, el representante de la arquidiócesis, representándonos en el quinto encuentro que va a suceder este año. Cuéntanos un poco acerca del encuentro y cómo se involucran las parroquias a nivel local.
Bueno, el quinto encuentro es una reflexión que tiene 5 sesiones y en resumen, esas 5 sesiones nos deben de llevar a implementar la alegría del Evangelio del Papa Francisco a nuestros ministerios y cómo podemos forjar misioneros discípulos que puedan salir a las periferias y poder compartir el encuentro con Jesucristo. Y la manera en que las parroquias se pueden envolver es que vamos eventualmente a enviar una carta por parte del arzobispo y por parte de nuestra oficina a cada párroco para que elija un grupo de 5 líderes aproximadamente y vengan a una capacitación donde van a recibir cómo es que van a manejar esa reflexión. Después regresan a la parroquia, invitan a los ministerios y les van a invitar a que vivan esas 5 reflexiones que básicamente consiste en cómo podemos forjar misioneros discípulos.
Ernesto, muchísimas gracias, Dios te bendiga y un saludo a nuestros televidentes.
Claro que sí, muchas bendiciones. Vamos a tomar el reto de este congreso que nos invita a confiar en Jesús y a seguir compartiéndolo en lo que hacemos.
Gracias. All right, and we also have another person from the Office of Religious Education, Victoria Radley, is that right?
Yes, Victoria Radley Smith.
How are you today? What does it feel like to end such a beautiful 3-day extravaganza?
It feels wonderful. So this was actually my first time with the Office of Religious Education. I'm new in the Youth Ministry Division, and as the coordinator for Youth Day, I was just so impressed with all of the young people and all of the coordinators that are here serving our young church, and then to see that continue on for the rest of the weekend with our adult portion of the Congress.
What were you doing before you were doing this role in the office?
I was a youth minister in the Archdiocese for about 10 or 11 years, serving in different parishes in San Fernando. And I have had experience with the Youth Day coordinating team before, so this was a blessing, and it was great to continue to work with so many great people.
What stood out about Youth Day for you this year? Is there a moment, an experience in particular that you're going to write down in your journal and sort of reminisce on?
I was so impressed with the young people who shared their stories as MCs, and then those who were giving some witness accounts on our stage, and just how well prepared they were and how willing they were to share how What Are You Waiting For has really, our theme, has really touched their lives, made a difference, and they were able to convey that in front of so many young people in a high-pressure situation. That was wonderful.
That's awesome. In terms of parting words, this is your first year in the leadership of, you know, the event. What would you say to people that haven't ever taken a leap of faith and you know, come to Los Angeles for this event? How would you encourage them to, you know, take that step next year?
Well, I think our themes for 2018 really lend ourselves to that. Dare to believe for Youth Day and then rise up for Congress. So this is the year. If you've not experienced it, please come out and join us if you can. Certainly, we always have our live stream, which is great, but there's nothing like being here. So take that leap of faith and experience your faith in this way. Join us for Congress 2018.
Thank you so much, Victoria. God bless. And we continue here. Everyone is pretty much sort of wrapping up and sort of gathering and taking the next step for their weekend. But as Victoria said, next year, the dates have been broadcast March 15th through the 18th. The theme is Rise Up. And we're back here in Anaheim, California for 2018. And, you know, take advantage of all the resources that are going to be on the website. As we, you know, talk to other friends, we're going to go talk to our brother from the Office of Religious Education or the Office of Liturgy up in Northern California. I don't know exactly what it is, but tell us who you are and what you do.
Hi, my name is John Michael Reyes, and I am a campus minister at Santa Clara University. And yeah, I help out with the Office of Worship up at the Diocese of San Jose.
And you're a regular participant. You're kind of part of the sort of greater Congress family. What stood out this year about the event in particular?
Wow, what stood out is definitely the image and the aspect of mentoring. As you've seen with Valimar and our two new cantors, it's just the aspect of looking to the future to embrace trust and to move on in that. And I see that every day of Congress, of people just building each other up in community and building up one another so that we can continue the good work that is Congress for the future.
And what is it about this event that continues to draw so many people, you think? Because year after year, people don't seem to tire, you know? So what is it about the event that you could maybe share with people watching that haven't taken that leap of faith and purchasing a ticket and coming to LA? How would you incentivize them?
Oh, how would I incentivize that? Definitely, you just have to come and experience the church that gathers, the church that is prophetic and lively and building community. So to come to Congress is I like to call it my spiritual booster shot. Is that it comes at a time when ministry gets to become fatigue and I get tired, but being here with everyone, being here with people who speak my language and can understand who I am through the lens of ministry, not just catechetical formation, but through worship, through music, through art, bring people alive through color and sound. Definitely this is the place to be, and as everyone jokes around, it is the happiest place on earth, not just because of our location, but because everyone wants to be here and wants to experience what it means to be a church alive and growing and learning from one another.
Well, thank you so much, John Michael. We really appreciate it. God bless, and have a great time in Northern California.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
All right. And as he was saying, a perfect segue to our two other speakers right now. As he's talking about mentoring, we see the young church that has sort of now been imbibed into the liturgical experience with Val sort of passing the torch. We have two amazing people. We have Lorenzo Rangel Santos and Linda Gwen. All right. How is it that you guys got involved? Obviously, you've always been participating. We saw you doing the psalm last year. You know, what was it that drew you to the Congress Cantor Choir situation?
You know, I love how it's so selfless, you know, because I feel like a lot of people think that maybe some people just want to sing for the congregation just to showcase their talents, you know, and in that sense, it can kind of paint it in a very selfish light. But I mean, we do this because what's more important are the words that we're saying. And so we're glorifying God and we're making sure that we're uniting everyone together under one God. And so in that sense, I love how it's very selfless and it shows that we're all literally a church together.
And what is it like, Linda, to have to sing in three languages and sort of keep all the languages together, you know? And for you this year, that meant three languages. So what was that experience like learning, rehearsing?
Luckily, I grew up speaking Vietnamese, so I know my Vietnamese has an American accent to it, and I'm sure my Spanish is, you know, taking the steps to get there. It was challenging, but it was exciting, and I welcome the challenges. It's great. And I have a great support team. I mean, between Anna and John and Tony and Chris, they're always trying to help me, so it's fantastic.
So when you first found out that you were going to be in the cantor role, what was the first thing that went through your head?
I laughed. It felt very surreal because I remember coming here when I was 11 and I saw Tony and Val up there and I was like, oh, that's so cool. And then a couple years later, I was invited to sing in Vietnamese. And then I never thought that I'd be asked to actually step into the cantor role. So I'm very honored and blessed and grateful to have the torch passed down. And it's nice to be able to represent the young adults.
And what about you, Lorenzo? What was the first sort of thought that went through your head when you knew that you had to assume the responsibility?
I was definitely dumbfounded, and I was actually very concerned. You know, I'm not going to lie, I was very fearful. You know, I wasn't sure if I'd be able to, you know, take on such a big task, especially because, I mean, you know, this isn't just your normal going to church every Sunday, you know, and just singing for a regular congregation. I mean, there's thousands of people here, and so, you know, of course, there's that pressure of just wanting to do well and, you know, having big shoes to fill. I mean, yeah, I was definitely feeling the pressure, but, I mean, I realized, you know, how much of a family everyone was, and everyone was just so nice, and I absolutely love that, and they made me feel, like, so comfortable. So, yeah.
That's so awesome, and what's so great about this picture here is that you have our former leader, Sister Edith Prendergast, embracing the two young people that, you know, she knew and loved. Hi, Sister Edith, how are you?
Fine, just great. I'm so delighted to have young people. I was watching their young faces tonight, and I think that was one of my goals always, to enable and empower young people to take it up and move on from there, and you did it beautifully. I'd give you A+ each.
Thank you.
And what is it like? You're kind of like our ex-president, you know, now you're like chilling and you're sitting down and just watching everything with restful eyes and no anxiety. What is it like to be just another joyful participant?
It's a wonderful thing, although I have to say, I've always enjoyed Congress, even when I was the director directing it, because I was working with such great people like all of you and others. But now I can kind of sit back and see also how it continues to grow and develop, and that makes me feel very, very good. So I know that God is in charge and that God is working through all of us in continuing to share this good news and to make us all disciples, missionary disciples.
Mm-hmm. And what are some parting words that you have for those that are watching online as we sort of bridge between the theme of embracing trust and then rising up next year? What are some words of encouragement that you can give us as we move into 2017 with full force?
Yes, I think we've been in a time of a kind of darkness and light. And I think to be able to rise up next year will be a very important theme for us, because I think that's the call that hope and trust calls us to, really rise up and believe in a God who is with us on the journey, a God who rests in us, and this God calling us to rest in Him. And so I think we will be all right. And it's a wonderful theme for next year.
Well, thank you so much. This is the picture of Congress. We have different races, different generations, different ministries that come together to make all this happen. And you are also very important in that journey and that experience. You're part of our family as well. So we thank you with open hearts for trusting us with this coverage and with the whole participation throughout the weekend. We send you with joy and light to your communities of faith so that you can empower other people, empower your young people to become strong members of the faithful laity. God bless. We'll see you next year. For now, I'm Alex Venegas for the Office of Religious Education of the Archdiocese. Take care and be good.